Good morning and happy...
I cannot.
In light of COVID-19, Malaysian Airlines is offering free date changes to customers subject to terms and conditions. Meanwhile, there's also a new coronavirus app that uses malware to steal credit card information and other personal details. Xiaomi has also just launched a new mid-range smartphone series in India, and we could be seeing over-ear Apple headphones for the first time. So as mentioned, the COVID-19 outbreak is continuing to develop. As of 8 a.m. on the 13th of March, 114 countries have been affected with a confirmed case total of over 128,000. So the impact of the coronavirus outbreak on several sectors has been pretty severe. And one of the sectors that's most heavily hit by the outbreak, of course, is the travel industry. For example, the travel ban for Malaysians to and from Italy, Iran, and South Korea, as well as the recent cancellation of the MWC 2020 in Barcelona. But if you're worried about any future bookings you may make, Malaysian Airlines is offering a one-time free date change for bookings made between the 10th and 31st of March 2020. The flexible rebooking option is open to passengers whose bookings are for travel dates between the 10th of March till the 31st of December 2020. Additionally, these rebookings must be made by the 31st of May 2020 and the new travel date must be completed by the 31st of December 2020. Also, for those that are traveling to severely impacted places like Japan, South Korea, or Saudi Arabia, Malaysian Airlines is offering refunds subject to terms and conditions. Some new mid-range contenders from Xiaomi are here, the Redmi Note 9 Pro and the Redmi Note 9 Pro Max. So both models share a lot of the same huge features, although there are some differences. Unfortunately, there's also no 90Hz refresh rate unlike the new Realme 6. So the headlining model is the Redmi Note 9 Pro Max with a larger 6.67 inch Full HD Plus display, which comes with a center aligned punch hole camera. So that's powered by a Snapdragon 720G that can be mated with up to 8GB of RAM and 128GB of UFS 2.1 storage. So there's also a pretty massive 5020mAh battery, and you can charge it via USB-C with the 33W charger that comes out of the box. So the rear camera setup has a very similar look to the Huawei Mate 20 Pro, although of course the specs are pretty different. So there's a 64MP main camera, an 8MP ultra-wide shooter, a 5MP macro shooter, and a 2MP depth sensor. So there's no telephoto lens, so no optical zoom, but there is a 32MP front-facing camera for selfies. Meanwhile, the Redmi Note 9 Pro has the same Full HD Plus 6.67 inch display as the Max, the same Snapdragon 720G processor, as well as the same 5020mAh battery. So one of the biggest differences is the maximum memory and storage configurations, 6GB of RAM and 128GB of UFS 2.1 storage. The camera setup is also a little bit downgraded. You have a 48MP main camera and a 16MP front-facing camera for selfies. So the Note 9 Pro will be going on sale in India on the 17th of March, while the Pro Max model will go for sale on the 25th of March. Pricing-wise, the Note 9 Pro will start at 12,999 Indian rupees, which is about 748 ringgit, while the Pro Max will start at 13,999 Indian rupees, which is about 862 ringgit. So we don't have official availability for the Malaysian market just yet, but we do expect to see the new Redmi Note 9 make its way to Malaysian shores soon. So I know many of us do enjoy using AirPods because of their seamless connectivity with Apple devices like iPhones, Macs, or even iPads. That said, we haven't yet seen an Apple-branded on-ear pair of headphones, so that's something that could be coming soon. So a new set of icons has been discovered within the iOS 14 code by the folks over at 9to5Mac. So the two new icons spotted, one black and one white, could mean the first pair of Apple-branded on-ear headphones. And no, Beats Solo Pros do not count as Apple-branded headphones. So you can't tell much from the icons other than the fact that they're headphones and that there are two color options. The look and size of the ear pads also indicate that they are over-ears, not on-ears, so that's also something that's pretty interesting. So usually over-ear headphones have better noise cancellation and sometimes they're more comfortable to wear in the long term because of their size. But speaking of size, over-ear headphones are almost always bulkier than on-ear headphones. So when I think of over-ear Bluetooth headphones, I think of the WH-1000X Mark III's. So even though Sony's over-ear headphones have been around in the market for some time now, since 2018, they are still the go-to headphones for a lot of people. So if Apple is actually launching a high-end pair of over-ear headphones, I think that they would definitely be gunning for the Sony WH-1000X Mark III's. So if you couple the intuitive nature of Apple's headphones together with the comfort and the noise cancelling of over-ear headphones, I think that we might have something pretty interesting coming from Apple. But the Sony WH-1000X Mark III's are definitely hard to beat. So the coronavirus is affecting us in more ways than just our health. There has been some new malware making the rounds online that is designed to trick people into revealing their credit card information and other personal details by hiding within a coronavirus information app. So I think I'm gonna mispronounce this or something, but this particular malware is called AzoRoute and it was first seen in 2016. So infected PCs lose browsing history, cookies, passwords, cryptocurrency keys, and more. The malware even downloads more malware, so this is something that you definitely need to avoid. So the app looks identical to the Johns Hopkins University coronavirus app and it looks pretty harmless. But when the download file is executed, duplicates of the files are then created and the malware is installed. So to be safe, you should only download from sources that you trust. If you want to stay updated on the latest statistics on the coronavirus outbreak, you can follow the Malaysian Ministry of Health on Twitter and Facebook. So again, don't download files from any unknown sources, even if you receive links on WhatsApp. So what do you think about the stories we talked about in today's episode? I'd love to hear what you think, so leave it in the comment section below. As always, if you enjoyed the video, remember to give it a thumbs up, like our Facebook page, subscribe to our YouTube channel, and always hit the notification bell icon to stay updated on future videos. So that's all for today. This is Nick signing off. Bye.